New content alert. I repeat, new content alert.
Woo!
So, it's time again for a new collection to be added into the game, and it is called the RGX 11Z Pro Bundle, coming in at 8,700 Valorant points. This new collection that I'm going to assume is an Ultra tier is going to include 5 upgrades. 4 of the upgrades are variations, and the 5th, just so they can squeeze as much Radiant out of us as possible, is for a stat tracker. That's right, you heard it. Valorant is finally getting a stat tracker in the game. However, there's some sad and unfortunate news about that, and that is that the stat tracker is not permanent. It's not going to track every single elimination that you get in every single game. It's only going to work for the single game that you're in. Right now, I'm entirely unsure exactly how specifically that gets, but as far as I can tell from all the leaks that I've seen and people who have had early access to it, if you were to get 5 eliminations in one game, not just one round, then at the end of the game, your gun would say 5 eliminations. If you were to get 25 eliminations in one game, not just one round, then your weapon would say 25. So it's pretty cool. But before we dive any deeper, I'm your not Justin, and it's good to see you guys again. It is 4:30 a.m. right now, and I just wanted to give you guys the important facts before I sort of started, you know, going on a tangent and talking about all this and when it's going to come out and all that sort of thing. But, you know, it's good to see you. Good morning. I can't sleep. I'm having a hard time with sleeping. Like the video if you're tired, but let's continue talking about this. There's quite a bit to unpack and quite a bit to look forward to when this comes out. So if you couldn't tell by now, the entire theme of this collection is graphics cards. They made a collection themed off of graphics cards. That's wonderful. Does this collection look really cool from pictures and videos and stuff that I've seen? Yeah, I think it looks really cool. And I think that when this does come out, it's going to be ultra popular. This will be a really cool item to use in Deathmatch because of the stat track feature. It's incredibly unfortunate that it's not a permanent stat tracker, and I don't really understand why it's not, but part of me wants to say that I understand why it wouldn't be. Simply maybe just because it might just be too complicated to code into the entire game yet, or maybe that's not the vision that they have for their game. I don't know, I'm not a developer, but I think as a consumer, I can confidently say that on your behalf as well, being the viewer, we're both consumers and we both want permanent stat trackers. That would be really sweet. So I don't know why we're not being given that, especially when you have to shell out the amount of money every single time a new collection comes out if you want to get the new skins. Like, we really got a cool one-off collection being the infantry collection where that was only $29. And now it's like ever since then, every collection's like at least 90. So I feel like, why not give us the permanent stat tracker if we're gonna be paying that much money anyways? And I will get into that. But before I do, I just want to talk about all the positive stuff first. So in case you missed it, here the picture is again. This collection is including a Frenzy, a Vandal, a Katana with a brand new animation, not just the KTAC animation, but a brand new Katana animation, a Guardian, and a Stinger. And what's cool about the Stinger being added is that I believe that this collection is giving us the second Stinger finisher that we have at all. The first one being the Sovereign. So just based off of that alone, I'm pretty excited about it because I do feel that there's a lot of weapons in the game that are sort of missing skins with upgrades. Like, a good example would be the Stinger, as well as the Bulldog just only recently getting its second upgradable with finishers being the Spectrum alongside the Glitch Pop. And then like the Judge doesn't really have that much either. It has the Elder Flame and the Glitch Pop. So, you know, it's good that they're adding in more for stuff that doesn't have so much already. But anyways, to move on, these are the 4 different variants here. Remember, this is graphics card themed. So there's a red, purple, green, and yellow variant, as well as this comes with a gun buddy that is interactable within the game. Gun buddy itself is just a graphics card. And what's really cool about this gun buddy is that, I could be wrong, I'm not so up to date on my gun buddy terminology, but this might only be the second gun buddy in the game that interacts with stuff that you do while you're playing. So for instance, the other gun buddy that interacts when you shoot is this gun buddy that looks like a cow. It's like a regular cow, and then it turns angry when you fire. You guys probably know what it is. I don't know the name of it off the top of my head. It's 4 a.m. right now. I can't do it. But this one, when you fire, it spins. And that's really sweet. Little details and interactable stuff is what we live for as community. But yeah, to bring the conversation a little bit further, I'd like to touch base again on the stat track feature of this and the Katana. The Katana, a lot of people I'm seeing just right off the get-go for this being announced for the past 2 hours now, or like hour or so, whatever it's been. A lot of people are complaining and saying like, oh no, another sword, another katana, it's just the KTAC katana. I too would be incredibly sad if they released just another sword. But this is not just another sword. This is a special animation. And it's literally like something that a samurai would do. When this actually comes out into the full game and you guys get to actually see this for the first time, you're going to flip out and you're going to want it. I think that this might be one of the biggest melee items to be added into the entire game. Like, at all. I don't know how people are going to feel about it just yet, and I'm going to post a poll about it, but this could be a top 5 or even like a top 3 melee skin. And it's important to note too that when you brandish any of the weapons or the melee, that it lights up and it changes colors and stuff like that, sort of like the Spectrum. But again, think graphics card. That's what it looks like. Moving forward, though, this next part that we're going to talk about is a little bit on the negative side, and I just want to explicitly say that I will not allow like any bashing of the devs in my comment section, and I want you guys to reserve the right to your opinion, of course, but keep it positive and be constructive and not destructive in the comment section. I would really appreciate that from you. You're all a bunch of good people, and I know that, but let's get into it. And this isn't supposed to be a dig at Valorant or Riot. I love the game, and I love the dev team. They put a lot of effort into the game, and it's very clear that they do so. But the most egregious part about this collection coming out is that there's 5 tiers of upgrades. Right now, until the collection comes out, we don't know exactly how much Radiant you're going to have to spend on it, but it's looking like if you want to just get all of the upgrades and the stat tracker, that you're going to be spending a minimum of 40 Radiantite. And this is not including if you want a variant or not, which could make it go up to 50 or 60, potentially. So to put it into perspective as well for you, if you were to get the Elder Flame when that first came out, or the Spectrum when that first came out recently, those two collections were like $110 a piece. Super expensive. And that's an Ultra Edition. Both of those are Ultra Edition tiers. With this is not an Ultra Edition. This is a Premium Edition starting at 8,700. It's 8,700, which is not that much of a difference from the Ultra. And you have to either already have saved up Radiantite, and if you don't have it, then the only other way that you could get it is waiting for the next Battle Pass, or, heaven forbid, buying even more Radiantite, which is super expensive as it is. And for a company that has went on record saying that they want to differentiate the tiers explicitly, the Ultra Edition tier and the Premium Edition tier really blend together simply because of the Radiantite. There's not really much of a difference other than, one, you're paying $30 more. So I don't really get that. And that alone is my only gripe at all about this new collection coming out. And really, it's nothing new. Like, I think the developers know that it's really expensive. I think us as a community can all agree that it's super expensive. But at the same time, they know that we're going to buy it anyways, and we know that we're going to buy it anyways. So it's like, what is one to do about it? But yeah, I'm super tired. I should be asleep right now. My sleeping medicine is just not working. Let me know what you guys think about the new RGB GTX, like, really confusing name, not catchy name, collection that's coming out. It really doesn't have a catchy name, and people are just going to be calling it the NVIDIA collection, like the graphics card collection or something like that. But, you know, let me know your opinions on it. And of course, I will be posting a poll on this so you guys can vote and have an even deeper discussion on it. This collection, I'm pretty sure, is coming out in like a day and a half or something like that, so be looking forward to it. As always, I'm Justin, and you're not. Like the video, subscribe if you're new, click the bell for notifications so you don't miss a single video ever, even if there's a tornado. And I love you guys, and I'll see you in the next one.